Zach Jones will come to the plate. There's a strike on the outside corner, and that will let Hayes head on down to second unchallenged. One and one to count. And a shot down the first baseline, foul. Now Larson out in front, one and two. Trying to get out of a jam here, and a hard shot right to the first baseman, Jake Metke. And Zach Jones will ground out to end it. And that will be it for the first inning. So the T-Birds threaten, leave second and third. They'll be stranded. We'll come back with the top of the second next.
Realtor Tommy Lowe of the Green Realty Group is the proud sponsor of the ESN Players of the Game. Remember, when you're looking to buy or sell your home, you need a partner in real estate success, and that's Tommy Lowe. Tommy believes in community and is involved as a youth football and soccer coach while supporting high school students. This is the commitment you get as your partner in real estate success with Tommy Lowe. Call Tommy direct at 360-791-3854 or go to his website at TommyLoweRealtor.com. That's TommyLoweRealtor.com Realtor.com. Tommy Lowe is your partner in real estate success. What does sportsmanship look like? It can be shown by helping a fallen player up, celebrating inexcessively, not arguing with officials, and shaking hands with opponents before and after a contest. As a participant, you represent not only yourself, but your team, school, and community. Do so with fair play, just play fair. A message from the Washington Interscholastic Activities Association.
And we are back here at Tumwater T-Bird Field. Aberdeen. We'll lead it off with Jake Metke, followed by Josh Collette and Hunter Oldham. Logan Chase will fire away down low for ball one. There's a strike right at the knees. Strike outside corner and low. And there is a pop fly out to right field. That'll be handled by Logan Hayes, and Metke is out. And the fly out to right. So here comes Josh Collette. His first at bat and take ball one. Logan Chase delivers. That'll be down low and outside, I guess, that time. 2-0 the count. There's a foul tip. 2-1. Aberdeen looking to get going here in the EBCO 2A. 0-2. There's a little grounder to Andrew Poulard. He'll scoop it up and have him easy for three. And five straight down. Now, Oldham did lead off with a walk, but ended up getting picked off at third, at second, that is. So they did go down 1-2-3 in the first inning. Not the traditional way. Hunter Oldham would get up, big guy here. Number six hitter, the DH. And there's a strike on the outside. That'll miss on the inside. Even the count at 1-1. Oldham will slice that one foul down the first baseline. 1-2 the count. Time called at the plate by Oldham. Two down here in the top of the first. No one on for Hunter Oldham. In the hole here, 1-2. Here comes Chase. And out on top of it is Oldham. Foul ball. We'll do it again. Grant Larson, the pitcher, is on deck. There's a little slow roller to Noah Andrews, but he'll have time to get him. And Hunter Oldham is down 6-3. And another 1-2-3 inning here for Logan Chase and the Tabers. Go to the bottom of the second. Michael Weiger, Easton Sonnenfeld, and Andrew Pilar set to go for the Tabers next.
Port Centralia supports all students in their endeavor to reach greatness from the classroom to the field. The Port Centralia knows our students are the key to our future, just like the port can be the key to yours. The Port Centralia is located halfway between Portland and Seattle, with easy I-5 access both north and south and rail links. You'll find low taxes in Lewis County, affordable housing, good schools, and an innovative community college, all important aspects for your growing business. The Port Centralia has the space you need for manufacturing, warehouse, office space, and developable land. Retail owners, listen up. Our new Centralia Station 40-acre retail and office complex is coming soon. We have high-profile space for you right off I-5. For more information on Port Centralia opportunities, call us today at 360-736-3527 or go online to the Port Centralia website at portcentralia.com. Your business future awaits at the Port of Centralia.
And back here at T-Bird Field, after an inning and a half, no score, Tumwater will lead it off here in the bottom of the second. Michael Weiger, first baseman. Grant Larson back on the hill, faced five batters in the first. T-Bird stranded runners on second and third. Pitch a strike. Nice little turn on that one for strike two right on the inside corner. Weiger now got to protect. That one misses. Larson. Swing and a miss, and down he goes. The throw down to first is Jackson Larson dropped the ball, but strikeout, first strikeout of the game for Larson. So here comes the DH for Tumwater, Easton Sonnenfeld. Try to get something going here for the T-Birds. Take ball one. Swing and a miss. One and one the count. Swing and a miss again out in front. Sonnenfeld. One and two the count. Larson starting to get into a groove here for the Bobcats. That one will miss inside as soon as they say that, of course. Ball goes to the backstop. It was a swing and a miss in the second strikeout of the ball game. Back to back for Larson. That'll bring up Andrew Pular.
That'll bring up the keeper, second baseman, number 21, Andrew Pular.
Austin Pular on deck. Strike. One and one the count. Strike two. Larson trying to strike out the side here. Fires, and Pular says, not going to happen. He'll drill one way out to left field, left center field, and he'll have a stand-up double. Andrew Pular with two strikes, unloads. Going to bring up Austin Pular. Here comes the lefty with two down now. As Andrew saw that coming the whole way and uncorked into the gap.
Three, Austin Pular.
Here comes Austin. That'll be up high and away. Ball one. Swing and a miss. One and one the count here. Noah Andrews, leadoff hitter, on deck. The balk is going to be called. That'll move Andrew Pular over to third now. So the ball gets behind. Jackson Larson could score from third. One and one the count. There's a shot out to right field, but right at Swenson. He doesn't even have to move. Austin got it. Good wood on that, as they say, but right at Swenson, and that will retire the side. And the T-Birds will strand another one. They've left three on base in two innings. We'll be back as the Bobcats will send Grant Larson, Milan Jandu, and Austin Lawrence to the plate next.
Proactive Physical Therapy in Tumwater, Olympia, and Lacey has made a huge name in training young athletes. But Proactive is much more than that and caters to all individuals coming back from any type of injury. If you have injured yourself and you need to get back in the game or simple day-to-day life activities, call Proactive Physical Therapy today for an appointment and start your way back to feeling good. Proactive Physical Therapy accepts all insurance, car insurance, workers' comp, Medicare, and VA. You owe it to yourself to feel good and productive. So contact Proactive Physical Therapy in Tumwater, Olympia, and Lacey.
Pacific Mobile Structures are big supporters of kids and athletics. Pacific Mobile Structures is the leader in temporary structures. If you are in need of temporary office space on a work site or for overflow space, or if your building is in need of major renovation, Pacific Mobile Structures can keep your company at work. Pacific Mobile Structures has a wide variety of square footage to fit your needs, and the structures do not have to be temporary. Pacific Mobile Structures can also offer you permanent space for a fraction of the cost to build your own. Go online to check out Pacific Mobile Structures.
Grant Larson leading it off here for Aberdeen here, the number seven hitter. Three up, three down, three up, three down for the Bobcats here. Grant going to try and help his own cause. Little grounder over to Andrew Poulard. He'll handle it, and an easy 4-3 put out for the T-Birds. And seven retired in a row. Well, not in a row, but kind of. How do you say that? Seven up, seven down. That's all we can say. Wasn't exactly in that particular order, but it doesn't matter. Same outcome. Milan Jandu is on now. Up for Aberdeen. Foul straight back. We'll get away from Davis. 2-1 the count on Jandu. Trying to become the second base runner for Aberdeen, the leadoff hitter. Oldham did get on via walk, but then was picked off a second by Logan Chase. And a beautiful tag out there by Noah Andrews. There's strike one, or strike two, I should say, to Jandu. 2-2 the count. That'll miss down and away. Full count, 3-2, one down, no one on. And a timeout as Davis is going to go out and have a chat with Logan. All set to go here. Here comes Chase. Just missed, and that'll be the second walk of the ball game. And Jandu will get on board. And he'll come. Here comes Austin Lawrence, the number nine hitter.
That brings up the second baseman, Austin Lawrence.
We'll try to keep this going. Come on, Austin. ball. Jandu with a short lead over there, being held on by Wagger. And a pop up down the right field line, hustling over, and that'll be out of play. Doing a good run out there, Logan Hayes. And Wagger back from his first base position, but that'll get a over the fence and into the parking lot. The count now, 1-1. Down low. Davis, a nice dig out there to keep Jandu on first. And there's another pop fly, and that again will also get out into the parking lot over there to the right down the first base line. Count will remain here, 2-2. There's a little floater, a little stinger there by Pilar, and almost turned the double play. Good backup there by Jackson Davis. So the line out to Pilar, almost got Jandu. Instead, Chris Holdem will come up to bat with two down. And Holdem walked his first at bat, stole second, and then was picked off a second for the second out of the first inning. So here we go. Logan Chase will come to the plate, swinging a miss. Nice off-speed pitch that time by Logan. Jandu with a short lead over there at first. Two down here in the top of the third inning, no score. Swinging a miss. Holdem over the top of that one. Bobcats have not left any runners on. T-Birds have left three on. There is a pop-up, and that'll go foul down the first base side. Here comes Chase. That'll be low and outside. Good idea there. That pitch has been... A pitch close to that has been called a strike for most part, but just couldn't get Holdem to chase it. 1-2 the count here, two down. There's strike three right down the pipe. I think Holdem was looking for something that was not that, as Logan Chase gets his third strikeout of the ball game to retire the side. And Aberdeen will strand one this time as we go into the bottom of the third inning. And leading off, top of the order, Noah Andrews, Noah Circle, and Jackson Davis. Back in a moment.
Pacific Sports Spa is now open in Chehalis. Are you an athlete, former athlete, or suffering from athletic-type injuries? Then you need to stop by Pacific Sports Spa and check out the most cutting-edge therapy equipment assembled in one place in all of the Pacific Northwest. Pacific Sports Spa can help you deal with the pain and soreness of sprains, inflammation, or stiff joints and muscles. Check out the services offered by Pacific Sports Spa on their website at pacificsportsspa.com. Pacific Sports Spa is ready to help you get back in the game.
OB Cruise. Credit Union is your local credit union. At OB Credit Union, you can open a personal or checking account and plan for your financial future. Dave Littleton is a financial advisor and waiting to hear from you today. Dave can help plan for your future and put in safeguards for when times get tough, your future will be protected. OB Credit Union is a longtime community member and supporter of local students. Stop in today at OB Credit Union in Lacey, Tumwater, and Tenino.
And we're back here at T-Bird Field, leading off the top of, or the bottom of the third inning, the top of the order for the T-Birds. Noah Andrews, followed by Noah Circle, then Jackson Davis. Andrews ground out to short his first at bat. He'll take ball one. There's ball two. Here's a strike. 2-1. Larson, one walk and two strikeouts. No runs. Coming up a couple of hits, though. Swing and a miss. Even the count at 2-2. Gave up a base hit to Noah Circle in the first. And then a two-out double to Andrew Pilar in the second. There's a line shot down the right field line. Foul. Two and two the count. Just missed. It'll fill the count at 3-2. It'll be up high, and Larson will lose him for his second walk of the ball game. That'll bring up Noah Circle, who had the first base hit of the ball game. Andrews will get a good lead. He's got good speed over there at first. Quick move over. Larson knows it. We'll keep him close. So Andrews with a lead over there at first. Throw again over to first. And again dives back in there safely. Andrews with a lead. Throw back over to first, safe. Has yet to throw a pitch yet. Three throws over to first base. Let's see if Andrews gambles here. Larson. There goes Andrews, and a shot and a hit and run. That's into left field for a base hit. Andrews will turn second and round to walk into third base. And a heck of a base hit there by Noah Circle, his second base hit. And that'll bring up Jackson Davis. Chance to try to get the T-Birds on the board here. No outs, runners on the corners.
That brings up the catcher, number 22, Jackson Davis.
So here comes Davis, his first at bat. He flew out to right field. And this one will get underneath it, and that will drift foul and almost get a windshield there. Darn close. Good thing they parked in number 75 and not number 76. So 0-1 the count as Davis tried to lift one to the outfield. Throw over to first. Just getting in is Noah Circle. I think they were expecting, it was not expecting that. He's kind of flat-footed for a second. Nice move by Larson. Almost got him. Throw over to first again. Andrews now will take a lead at third. 0-1 the count here on Davis. No outs. T-Bird's threatening again. There goes Circle. Throw down to second. Not in time, and Circle will get the stolen base. So now runners on second and third. Shot out to center field. Coming on for the catch is Collette. And that will drive in the first run of the ball game. As Davis will get the sacrifice RBI. Here comes Logan Hayes, the right fielder, with one in and Circle out there on second base. We'll take a strike. Foul back, and quickly out in front is Larson. Oh, and two, here comes Larson. Shot right up the box, grabbed by the shortstop, fires over in time for the out. Nicely done there by Chris Oldham over to Metke. That'll move the runner over to third, but now two outs. And here comes Zach Jones. Zach in his first at bat. Grounded out to the first baseman to end the inning. The lefty will step up. And a little chopper right back to the pitcher. And Larson will take something off of that. And Jones made that a lot closer than it probably should have been. I think Coach Shriver's going, just get the ball over there. All right. They'll give up one. T-Birds break through with a 1-0 lead. Back in a moment. Top of the fourth coming up next.
Pacific Mobile Structures are big supporters of kids and athletics. Pacific Mobile Structures is the leader in temporary structures. If you are in need of temporary office space on a work site or for overflow space, or if your building is in need of major renovation, Pacific Mobile Structures can keep your company at work. Pacific Mobile Structures has a wide variety of square footage to fit your needs, and the structures do not have to be temporary. Pacific Mobile Structures can also offer you permanent space for a fraction of the cost to build your own. Go online to check out Pacific Mobile Structures.
The Pacific Athletic Center is excited about the expansion of our express basketball teams, featuring 5th through 8th grade and high school girls teams and boys teams 5th, 7th, and 8th grades. Players for the Express receive exposure to the highest level of competition. Our dedicated practice facility, individual training and coaching from our experienced staff, plus top-line gear and for parents, affordable pricing and available scholarships. Check out the PAC Express at PacificExpressBasketball.com or find our link under Youth Sports on the ESN homepage.
And welcome back to Two-Bird Field. Paul Beatty here on the Eli Sports Network. Tamar Aberdeen. Boys baseball action here on a Tuesday afternoon. 1-0. T-Birds break through in the bottom of the third, top of the fourth for Aberdeen. Here comes Blake Swenson along with Josh Germeau and Jake Metke as Logan Chase continues to be pretty razor sharp heading into the top of the fourth. Swenson's second chance. Swenson struck out looking his first. He thought he was going to draw a walk, and that's when we first saw that pitch right there, kind of low and outside. This umpire likes. He's been very consistent at it. And that'll even the count there at 1-1. There's a strike. Comes Chase. That one will be fouled away down the first base side and over into the parking lot. Time at the plate. Called by Swenson. Trailing in the count here, 1-2. Here comes Chase. Just misses low. 2-2. Germeau on deck. He struck out his first at bat. We'll look for redemption here. Hoping Swenson can get on. 2-2 count. He'll be outside, and that'll fill it. Comes Chase. Little chopper. It'll be grabbed by Andrews, the shortstop, and in time, a nice play there by Noah Andrews. Bend down Swenson, 6-3. I'm going to bring up
number 22, the third baseman, Josh
Germeau. Right-hander will dig in. There's a strike. Nice little curve there. Little movement on that one there for Logan Chase. That one up in his eyes. Had a little turn to it as well, and Germeau couldn't resist. Get a piece of it. Now he's in the hole, 0-2. Count, one down. Germeau swinging a miss. And he'll go down for the second time swinging. It's a fourth strikeout for Logan.
That'll bring up number 13.
Logan Chase. Here comes Jake Metke. He led off the top of the second with a flyout to right field, Logan Hayes. Metke will dig in, the big right-hander. That one will be too far outside, ball one. There's a strike right at the knees. Little tapper right back to Noah Andrews. Scoops, fires across, and 1-2-3, down they go. In order in the top of the fourth inning. T-Birds try to add to that 1-0 lead. We come back in the bottom of the fourth. Leading it off will be Michael Wagger, Easton Sonnenfeld, the DH, and then Andrew Poulard. Back in a moment.
Pacific Athletic Center, a locally owned nonprofit organization, is dedicated to developing quality youth sports programs at an affordable price. Our team practice rental rates start at $10 an hour for local Chehalis area teams. In addition to operating as a practice facility, the PAC is always adding to its offerings. From skill development to organizing and hosting competitive tournaments, there's always something new going on. To learn more about what's currently happening at the PAC, check them out on Facebook or visit the website at PacificAthleticCenter.com.
The Holiday Inn Express in Chehalis is pleased to support the student athletes that dedicate themselves to be the best they can be. The Holiday Inn Express offers large, clean rooms with an indoor pool, fitness center, spa, free breakfast, Wi-Fi, and business center. The Chehalis Holiday Inn Express also has two meeting rooms and can accommodate up to 100. Call for more details or go online at HIExpress.com. Or you can click on the Holiday Inn Express advertisement on the Eli Sports Network. When you are looking to stay overnight, remember the Holiday Inn Express.
Back here at T-Bird Field, Paul Beatty here on the Eli Sports Network as we go into the bottom of the fourth inning. 1-0, Tumwater scored in the bottom of the third. Grant Larson has gone the distance so far for Aberdeen, and his second walk ends up costing him a run. Fouled away. Strike two, 0-2 quickly. Larson out in front. Wagger struck out in his first at-bat. Finds himself behind the count again this time. Grant Larson looking for strikeout number three. And he'll get it. Wagger out in front. And Larson will get him swinging. That'll bring up Easton Sonnenfeld, who struck out in his first at-bat. That one will hit Sonnenfeld, and he'll head on down to first. Here comes Andrew Pilar, who doubled in his first at-bat with two out, then was stranded. Andrew looking to make good contact again. Big lead over there by Sonnenfeld. That one will float in a little high. We're over to first, and Sonnenfeld is back in time. So 1-0 here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Runner on first for the T-Birds. Trying to extend their winning streak here to 7-0 on the season, 4-0 in EVCO 2A play. Throw back just in time. Larson has a nice move over to first. Been a few close plays, has yet to pick one off, but keeping the T-Birds closer to first base. Throw back to first and back easily this time. Andrew Pilar will dig back in with a 1-0 count. Trying to keep Sonnenfeld right there at first. Is Grant Larson. There goes Sonnenfeld. Jackson Larson with a throw down, and it'll be broken up there by Sonnenfeld. Yeah, he got hit by the pitch. He gets hit by the throw down there. He goes. He'll take the stolen base, though, and now moves into scoring position for sure if Andrew can rip another one into the gap. That will definitely score Sonnenfeld. 2-0 the count. There's a strike. So 2-1 is the count. One down here. Tebers looking for an insurance run here out there on second base. And one misses. 3-1. Be up high, and Andrew Pillar will walk as well. Third walk of the game by Larson. And here comes Austin Pillar, who flew out to right field and the second inning for the T-Birds. Now would like to find a gap here or line one into the outfield to move the runners around. There's strike one. Runners on first and second. For the T-Birds, Sonnenfeld out at second. Andrew Pillar at first, and Austin Pillar in the left-handed batting box with Noah Andrews on deck. Larson now took something off of that one, and Austin got caught out there way out in front, 0-2 the count. That was a beautiful pitch. Austin says, yep, it was. I'll dig back in, though, and I'm ready for it. He'll look to protect the plate here with an 0-2 count. Strike three on the outside corner, and Austin couldn't pull the trigger. Nice pitch there by Larson. Now he's a pitch away from getting out of the inning with no further damage. Second out, here comes Noah Andrews. Noah grounded out to the shortstop in his first at-bat, and then walked and would come around to score in his second at-bat, only run of the game. There's a strike with a little bender there by Larson. Larson from the stretch, checks the runners. Little chopper, and that's going to be pulled foul. So out in front, 0-2 here, and the chance to get out of this is Larson. Down just 1-0. He can hope that his offense can come around. Here comes Larson, just misses outside. Sonnenfeld will go ahead and take third. Sonnenfeld will get over to third on the stolen base. Now Andrews with a 1-2 count, two down. There goes the runner down to second. Andrew Pillar will take it. So runners advance over to second and third. Noah Circle on deck. He'd love to get up. He's got two base hits in the game, solid hits. Strike three, and down goes Noah. He couldn't pull it either. It's a beautiful pitch by Larson. Hits that outside corner right at the knees, and the T-Birds will strand two. They've now stranded five in the ballgame. They've got one across, and they got the 1-0 lead. Haverty's going to try and make a difference here. Let's go into the top of the fifth next.
Health Nutrition Center in Centralia is your home base for nutrition. When you visit Good Health Nutrition Center, you'll find the largest selection of vitamins, supplements, and natural remedies. You may be surprised to also find a huge selection of healthy groceries such as gluten-free products, environmentally friendly products, organic fruits and vegetables, and items for specific diets like the diabetic diet. Good Health Nutrition Center, powering students and athletes from the inside out. Good Health Nutrition Center on Harrison in Centralia.
For student athletes, Centralia College is your college. If college feels out of reach financially, the Centralia College Foundation is here to help.
Hundreds of thousands of dollars in scholarships and financial aid are awarded to student athletes on an annual basis. So when you're deciding your future, Centralia College is your college. For more information on Centralia College and the Centralia College Foundation, visit centralia.edu. Centralia College, your college.
Back here at T-Bird Field, Paul Beatty here on the Eli Sports Network. 1-0 as we go into the top of the fifth. It'll be Josh Collette, Hunter Oldham, and Grant Larson be up to bat. Collette grounded out to second baseman Andrew Poulard in his first at-bat. Here comes Logan Chase. Good speed on that, but low. Count even now, 1-1. There's a fly ball out to center. Noah Circle will get underneath it. He'll handle it. One-handed catch, and Collette will fly out to center.
Now coming to plate, number 33, designated hitter Hunter Oldham.
Hunter Oldham now up. He grounded out to Noah Andrews to end the second inning. There's a strike. One and one the count. Time called at the plate by Oldham. One and one the count. Here comes Logan Chase. And a little flare to the second baseman, and Andrew Poulard will let it hit and easily gobble it up and throw down Hunter Oldham. 4-3. And two up, two down. That'll bring up Grant Larson.
That'll bring up number 12.
As the biggest threat to score on the day came from Oldham, the leadoff hitter. When he walked to lead off the game, got over to second on a steal, but then was picked off at second, and that's as far as Aberdeen has gotten since. Strike on Grant Larson here. 0-1 the count. Foul back. Owen 2, two down here. As Chase tries to mow him down, and he does. Beautiful turn on that one. His fifth strikeout, and Grant Larson will go down swinging. But another 1-2-3 inning for Logan Chase. The T-Birds will go into the bottom of the fifth with a 1-0 lead, and they will be sending up Noah Circle. He'll lead it off, followed by Jackson Davis, Logan Hayes. Back in a moment.
A new day is here. Charter Communications has completed the transaction with Time Warner Cable and Bright House Networks, growing the business to service more than 20 million customers in 41 states. Here is your chance to start a customer service career with a Fortune 100 company. Charter Communications offers excellent benefits, employee perks, competitive pay, set full-time schedules, and 5 weeks of training. For more information, visit www.charter.com/careers.
Working together for a common goal, that's what teamwork is all about. Tom and Karen Alderson and all the staff at Awards West Printwares congratulates all of our local athletes for the time and effort they have invested in learning to play their game and in learning how to be good teammates. At Awards West Printwares, we take a lot of pride in working as a team to provide quality custom awards, screen printing, embroidery, and banners. Alderson's Awards West Printwares on Kresge in Centralia.
We're back here. We have a new pitcher for the Aberdeen Bobcats. Austin Timmons will come in relief of Grant Larson. I don't see Larson has re-entered anywhere. It looks like Austin Lawrence is still out there at second. I don't see Grant Larson back in there anywhere else, but nonetheless, Noah Circle will lead off here, and he'll get out in front of this one. Austin Timmons will start off with a strike. A little miss. So we're going to miss by Circle. And it's now 1-2. Timmons with the wind. The outside. Comes Timmons, that'll be up high. It'll fill the count at 3-2. Be down low and Circle will draw the walk. So here comes Jackson Davis. Davis flew out to right field in his first at-bat, flew out to right field in his second at-bat, but that was a sacrifice fly that drove in the only run of the game so far for the RBI. That one will get away from Jackson Larson, and Circle will get on down. Second base on the pass ball. That one misses. 2-0. Side 3-0. Time's called by the field ump. We'll have to take a look at the mound. And they need something out there. I'm not sure what it is. Now the Clay Hill will come out with the landscape. A little landscaping is set to go here. And they'll try to reconfigure the mound with a 3-0 count. All right, we're going to take a timeout. We come back. We'll have everything back in order, we think, here on the Eli Sports Network.
Lewis County defense attorney Don Blair is known for his tenacious defense of his clients. Don Blair will battle for your rights and your freedom. These are qualities that Don will tell you he learned from his participation in sports. Don Blair knows and understands those values and was quick to support the Eli Sports Network. Don Blair defends citizens throughout Southwest Washington. So remember, when you, a loved one, or a friend find themselves in trouble, you want the first string, and Don Blair will stand by you in your time of need.
Looks like we're getting close to getting back at it. The umpires. The catcher come back. It's a 3-0 count on Jackson Davis. And Coach Clay Hill gets the job done out there. If you're watching this on the video replay, you may want to consider hiring Coach Clay to handle your landscaping needs at your house. There's a strike. Outside corner right at the knees. Going to be outside, and Davis will walk, and now the bases. Runners on first and second. Timmons, two up, two walks. Going to bring up Logan Hayes.
Now on the run for the catcher, number one, Hunter Murley.
Hunter Murley will come in to run for Jackson.
Coming to the plate for the Keybirds, number four, Logan Hayes.
Hayes walked in his first, ended up stranded at second, and then grounded out to the short in his second at-bat. There's a strike. So 1-0 Tumwater here in the bottom of the fifth. No outs, runners on first and second, and Austin Timmons in trouble here. Trying to work out of it. There's a little grounder right to the shortstop. Trying to go to third, and we'll get him in time. Nice play there by Chris Oldham over to Germeau to get the lead runner. Noah Circle for the first out. Murley will go to second. Hayes on the fielder's choice will end up at first base. And that'll bring up
number 23, Jacob Holbrook.
Jacob Holbrook, he'll bat for Zach Jones here. Holbrook's first at bat. That'll be outside. Nice stop there by Larson behind the plate to keep Murley over there on second. Swing and a miss by Holbrook. Good cut at it. Runner heads to third. Now a delay down to second. That'll hit the base runner, Logan Hayes. And the steal by Murley. Get over to third, and Hayes will end up taking second. So runners on second and third with one out, 2-1 the count here on Holbrook. There's a strike. That'll even the count at 2-2. Holbrook digging in, 2-2 count, trying to make something happen here. He'll pop that one up behind and out of play. Just trying to get a insurance run here. So far, nothing doing. Trying to break through here against Austin Timmons. So a shot right up the box and into center field for a base hit. And that'll score two. As they both come home here, two more runs will come across the plate here. Murley comes in from third, and Hayes from second on the one out RBI, two RBI base hit by Holbrook.
Number 14, Garrett Behrens.
So Garrett Behrens is up next. He'll bat for Michael Wagger here. And down to second goes Holbrook. He'll take it. The stolen base. T-Birds get a couple of insurance runs. Now go up 3-0 here in the bottom of the fifth. Two and oh the count. Here comes Timmons. There's a strike. Throw down to third, not in time. And Holbrook steals third. And there's a walk. And Behrens will head on down to first. Third walk of the inning here for Timmons.
That'll bring up the designated hitter number two, Easton Sonnenfeld.
Here comes Easton Sonnenfeld. Swing and a miss. And heading on down to second is Behrens. Strike. So 0-2 the count. Timmons one down here. Runners on second and third. Trying to limit the damage. That'll miss. Good eye there by Sonnenfeld. Good idea by Timmons, but Sonnenfeld not biting. Swing and a miss, and down goes Sonnenfeld. And that will bring up Andrew Pillar. Andrew, with a two-out double, was stranded back in the second and then would walk and be stranded in the last inning. And he'll go around, swing. Here comes Holbrook home, and that'll get past the pitcher, Timmons. And Holbrook will hustle home for a fourth run to go up 4-0 now. Well, I don't think it's 7-0. But that was an expensive run right there. Pillar now with Behrens over at third, still can pick up an RBI here. That is down low, and Larson will block that one. So 1-1 the count. Here comes Timmons outside. 2-1. Here comes Timmons. Foul tip off the mask from Larson. Two and two the count, two down. Timmons trying to get out of this. There's a grounder to Germeau. He'll fire across, and he will get Andrew Poulard. But the T-Birds will put three on the board and jump out to a 4-0 lead through five innings. Top of the sixth. Looks like Milan Chandu, Austin Lawrence, and then back to the top of the order with Chris Holden for the Bobcats. Back in a moment.
OB Credit Union is your local credit union. At OB Credit Union, you can open a personal or checking account and plan for your financial future. Dave Littleton is a financial advisor and waiting to hear from you today. Dave can help plan for your future and put in safeguards for when times get tough, your future will be protected. OB Credit Union is a longtime community member and supporter of local students. Stop in today at OB Credit Union in Lacey, Tumwater, and Tenino.
Chehalis GNC is the place to shop for quality vitamins and sports nutrition products. GNC offers a large selection of multivitamins to meet the needs of men, women, kids, and teens. Locally owned since 1993 by the Kerner family, Chehalis GNC invites you to come in today for a healthy new you. Ask about GNC's Gold Card program to save up to 40% every day on everything in the store. Chehalis GNC is located in the Twin City Town Center across from Starbucks. GNC, come in and live well.
And we're back here at T-Bird Field. Jandu will lead it off here for the Bobcats. Milan. Milan Jandu will face Logan Chase, and Logan stays out there and still firing. Strike one. It'll be Jandu and then Austin Lawrence. Back to the top of the order to hold him. 0-2 is Logan Chase again. Five strikeouts, two walks. Looking to deal here. And that one will be fouled off. Staying alive is Jandu. Jandu walked in his first at-bat. And I think this is only his second, isn't it? Yeah, second at-bat. That one will just miss, 1-2. Strike three, and down he goes. It's number six.
That'll bring up the Bobcat second baseman, number 18, Austin Lawrence.
Austin Lawrence now up. And he'll take ball one. Top of the sixth inning, five outs to work with if you're Aberdeen, and they've not had anyone pass second base. That was a leadoff hitter back in the top of the first. That'll be outside, 2-0. That was Oldham, who then was picked off of second. And that's the last time the Bobcats threatened to score. Comes Chase. There's a foul back. And there's a ball. 3-0. Check that, 3-1. There's a shot out to left field and over the head of the left fielder coming in and then having to retreat. Is that still Zach Jones out there? I think he re-entered as. So.
That'll bring up number two, the shortstop.
And guess what? This time, Logan Chase doesn't get to the seventh inning with a no-hitter. He gets to the sixth inning, and that does break up the no-hitter. So Lawrence on second with a double. And here comes Oldham. A chance to get the Bobcats on the board here. One down, runner on second. A curveball will miss inside. See if they try to pick off Lawrence, see if the Bobcats' memory is faded from the first inning. Swing and a miss. Nice pitch there by Chase. Up and in. Oldham couldn't catch up to it. 1-1. And that'll be fouled away. Now Chase out in front. 1-2. There goes the runner on a little hit and run. Maybe he hesitated. It was Lawrence. Now running down a few of the fouled off balls and a 1-2 count. Don't think that was a hit and run because Coach Schreiber's over there on Lawrence's case. What's the score? There's a little curveball, and that'll be grounded right to Austin Poulard. Fires across, and we'll get him. Barons with a nice stretch there. Garrett Barons, nice stretch, and Austin comes up with a nice play there for the second out. That is going to bring up Blake Swenson. Swenson grounded out in his last at bat to the shortstop. Struck out in his first, 0-2. He'll take strike one here from Chase. There's strike two. Beautiful pitch by Logan. There's a little chopper. That'll go right to Andrew Poulard. Andrew will fire it across, and that'll take care of the inning. 4-3. The T-Birds still lead 4-0. Bobcats did break up the no-hitter. The T-Birds still in control. Aberdeen will hit the field. The T-Birds will try to add to that 4-0 lead. Back in a moment. You better dance. Let's make a night.
You won't remember. Athletes, the time is now to get serious about improving yourself to reach your goals. We all know that college recruiters and professional scouts put a lot of importance on those tangible measurements, such as a 40 time, your vertical leap, cone drills, and so on. Proactive Physical Therapy in Tumwater has a special, unique training program that will improve your results across the board. If you are serious about raising your performance to the next level, you need to talk with the pros today at Proactive Physical Therapy. Check them out online or call for an appointment today.
The Visiting Nurses Foundation, in association with Assured Home Health and Hospice, provides essential services to home health and hospice patients and families. The Visiting Nurses Foundation funds programs, purchases medical equipment, and cares for the medically needy. You can help the mission of visiting nurses and get a great deal at the same time by shopping at the Visiting Nurses thrift shops in Centralia and Chehalis. Click on the ad on Eli Sports Network to the Visiting Nurses website for locations and more bargains. Visiting Nurses, there in your time of need.
And we're back here at T-Bird Stadium. And another change in pitchers here as Josh Germeau will come on to pitch for the Bobcats here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Hunter Oldham will come in and take third base as Timmons has a one inning and is out. Dustin Dahl is going to step up and bat for Austin Poulard here in the bottom of the sixth, followed by Noah Andrews and Noah Circle. There's strike one on Dahl. One and one to count. Here comes Germeau. I'm going to go way behind Dahl and ducks down out of the way for the 2-1 count. And now Dahl will step out. Just missed low. 3-1 to count on Dustin Germeau from the stretch, ready to go. Ball low, and Dahl will take his base down to first, and that'll bring up Noah Andrews. Noah ground out to short. Walked, would come around to score the first run of the ball game, and then would strike out. And he'll take strike one here. Dahl with the lead over at first. And strike two. Shot will be pushed foul. It'll hit the roof of the Performing Arts Center over there to the right. 0-2, the count remains. Dahl with the lead at first. Now strike three with a nice bender. It'll catch the inside corner. And the second time that Noah Andrews will go down. Gonna bring up Noah Circle. Circle with a pair of base hits. Take a strike. And then he'd walk in the fifth and get forced out at third. So he's been on all three times. He's come to the plate, trying to make it 4-for-4 here. There's a ball. His second hit moved Noah Andrews from first to third and was back in the third inning. Noah would then score on a sacrifice RBI fly by Jackson Davis. 2-1 the count. And a chopper down the third baseline foul to even it at 2-2. Shot out to center field for his third base hit of the ball game. Fourth time he's been on base. Dustin Dahl will get over to second. It's going to bring up Jackson Davis.
That brings up the keyboard catcher, number 22, Jackson Davis.
Down low, good stop there by Larson. That'll be up high and in. Fouled back. 2-1 the count. Josh Germo on the hill, and he'll lead off the top of the seventh when the Bobcats get there. Their last chance at the plate. That ball will hit in front, and Larson couldn't find it in time. Dahl will easily scurry over to third. And Noah Circle will get out to second base. Wind's starting to blow here. Again, a reminder, tomorrow we had the WF West at Black Hills game on the schedule. That's been canceled already. They moved that to today. So they're playing a doubleheader down in Chehalis. Game one started at 4:30. There's a shot and a right field, and that's going to score at least two. And a two RBI base hit there by Jackson Davis. So Dahl will score, and so will Noah Circle. That'll make it 6-0 here. With one out. Here in the bottom of the sixth.
Now running for the catcher, number 11, Dylan Grove. And coming to the plate, number
Dylan
one,
Grote will come in to run Hunter for Murley. Davis. And Murley is up to bat now. Hunter Murley for the T-Birds. There goes Grote. He'll slide in safely. And a strike called on Murley. So one out, two in, 6-0. Tumwater here in the bottom of the sixth inning. It was a nip and tuck game all the way till the bottom of the fifth. Grant Larson went a strong four innings, gave up just the one run. Gave up a few hits in there, but really had pitched well for Aberdeen. He was pulled in the fifth. Austin Timmons came in, walked a pair, and got into trouble right away. Ended up giving up two runs, and now Germo on the hill after a walk, strikeout, and a base hit. Gives up a two-run RBI, or two RBI base hit to Jackson Davis to make it 6-0. Swing and a miss by Murley. 1-2 the count. comes Germeau. I'm going to miss outside. 2-2. Lawrence and Oldham trying to keep Grote on base out there at second. Close. Comes the pitch. That'll be high and inside. That'll fill the count. 3-2. So Murley battling. Here comes Germeau. 3-2 count, and he'll step off. Keep Grote close. Germeau. There's strike three, and Murley couldn't pull the trigger. Second strikeout of the inning for Germeau. I'm going to bring up Jacob Holbrook.
That'll bring up number 23, Jacob Holbrook.
Holbrook had the big hit in the last inning. Two RBI base hit. Then would come around to score on a pass ball. Dive in there for the third run after stealing two bases. Time is called. There's a ball. Grote on at second there. Two down here in the bottom of the sixth inning. 6-0 Tumwater. Germeau and a shot in the left center field. And that'll score Grote. And another RBI by Holbrook. Gets inserted late into the lineup. And he's come up two hits and three RBI. Here comes Garrett Behrens, who walked last inning and would get stranded. And a meeting out on the hill with Germeau. Coach Schreiber out there having a word with his pitcher. And Jacob Holbrook. Not sure how you keep him out of the lineup after today's performance. He just might come in and steal our player of the game with his two at-bats. Logan Chase has been terrific on the hill, but I think I'm going to spoil the surprise right now. He just might have earned the play of the game there in the top of the first inning with that pickoff. Throw over to first by Germeau to keep Holbrook close. As they have been running T-Birds today. They've stolen second, I don't know how many times. Several. And third. Foul back by Garrett Behrens. And he'll fall behind here 0-1. Bobcats will have one more chance after they get this third out. There's a strike. Shot out to center field, and Josh Collette out there will wander underneath that and handle it for the third out, but three more will come in to make it 7-0 as we go to the top of the seventh inning. One last chance here for the Bobcats. Got to get seven across to force the bottom of the inning. See if they can get something going here next.
Realtor Tommy Lowe of the Green Realty Group is the proud sponsor of the ESN Players of the Game. Remember, when you're looking to buy or sell your home, you need a partner in real estate success, and that's Tommy Lowe. Tommy believes in community and is involved as a youth football and soccer coach while supporting high school students. This is the commitment you get as your partner in real estate success with Tommy Lowe. Call Tommy direct at 360-791-3854 or go to his website at TommyLoweRealtor.com. That's T-O-M-M-Y-L-O-W-E Realtor.com. Tommy Lowe is your partner in real estate success.
OB Credit Union is your local credit union. At OB Credit Union, you can open a personal or checking account and plan for your financial future. Dave Littleton is a financial advisor and waiting to hear from you today. Dave can help plan for your future and put in safeguards for when times get tough, your future will be protected. OB Credit Union is a longtime community member and supporter of local students. Stop in today at OB Credit Union in Lacey, Tumwater, and Tenino.
And we are back here as Josh Germeau will lead it off. Top of the seventh inning for the Bobcats. Looking to get someone on base any way he can. He struck out twice. And he'll swing again at Logan Chase, trying to go the distance here. He has been spectacular tonight, or this afternoon. There's another swing and a miss. Had his no-hitter broken up in the top of the last inning. Austin Lawrence with a double. So there's a little grounder right to Andrew Pular, and he'll have Germeau out easy, 4-3, and that'll bring up Jake Metke.
That'll bring up Jake Metke, number 13. One
will miss for ball one. Two and on the count. There's a strike. 2-1. There's a strike. 2-2. Here comes Chase. That will hit Metke. And that'll bring up Josh Collette. So Collette grounded out to second and flew out. I believe, yep, flew out to center in his two at bats. Hunter Oldham on deck. There's a strike by Logan Chase. Seven to nothing here in the top of the seventh. Logan Chase trying to go all the way here. He's got 6 1/3 in there. One down low, 1-1. There's a foul ball down the first baseline. That'll go off one of the school buildings there. 1-2, and Logan Chase out in front of Collette. Missed just low, 2-2. Here comes Logan. That'll be down and away. That'll fill the count, 3-2. Metke over on first with one down here. Chase. There is a foul back, and Collette stays alive. Hunter Oldham will run down the loose ball there for the umpire. And there is a fly ball again. That'll go behind us and out of play. Count remains full, 3-2. Collette will take a timeout here and reorganize himself. That'll be ball up and in, and that'll send Collette down to first. Do the third walk of the game for Chase, and Clay Hill is going to go out and have a word with Logan Chase. I'll bring up Hunter Oldham. Go out and just make sure he's doing okay. I don't think he's coming out. I'd be surprised if he is. Hunter Oldham grounded out to short in his first at bat. And then to second base in his, he is coming out. All right, we're going to have a pitching change. Change is made as Logan Chase will come out and not happy about coming out, but we got the wrong one going here, so we will take a timeout when we come back, see who they're bringing in. And it looks like that is going to be Landon Jordan come in to relieve here in the top of the seventh inning. We'll be back after this timeout.
For student athletes, Centralia College is your college. Centralia College offers volleyball, men's and women's basketball, baseball, and fast pitch teams, and one of the lowest tuition rates in the state. Centralia College is your college for Trailblazer athletics, associate and bachelor's degree programs, certificates, and workforce training. When you're deciding your future, Centralia College is your college. For more information, go to centralia.edu. Centralia College, your college.
Pacific Sports Spa is now open in Chehalis. Are you an athlete, former athlete, or suffering from athletic type injuries? Then you need to stop by Pacific Sports Spa and check out the most cutting-edge therapy equipment assembled in one place in all of the Pacific Northwest. Pacific Sports Spa can help you deal with the pain and soreness of sprains, inflammation, or stiff joints and muscles. Check out the services offered by Pacific Sports Spa on their website at pacificsportsspa.com. Pacific Sports Spa is ready to help you get back in the game.
And we are back here at T-Bird Field as Landon Jordan will come in for Logan Chase. He'll face Hunter Oldham, and he'll throw one outside, ball one. There's a strike. Time called at the plate. Jordan will throw through. 1-1 to count. One out. Runners on first and second. Metke at second. Collette at first. Here's Jordan, a little tapper. That'll go right to Behrens. He'll take it himself to get the second out. That'll move the runners. But now, two down. With who do we have at the plate here? This is going to be Jackson Larson. He'll get his first batting attempt here for the Bobcats. He's starting catcher, but was DH4. Now we'll get to take a swing. That one was down low by Jordan. A great stop by Davis. There's a little chopper right to first, and that is going to do it as Larson will ground it to Behrens, and Behrens will tag first base, and that will end it 7-0. Tumwater will take this one over the Aberdeen Bobcats. We'll take a timeout, come back with the postgame show next.
The clock has expired, and the game is over. And next is the postgame show on the Eli Sports Network.
Chehalis GNC is your vitamin, herb, sports nutrition, and winter wellness headquarters. Preparing yourself to combat the winter doldrums begins at Chehalis GNC. The nutrition pros at GNC can help you build a strong body inside and out with products such as probiotics, omega-3, multivitamins, and protein powders. Join GNC's Gold Card Club for even bigger savings in all your health and wellness needs. The Chehalis GNC is located in the Twin City Town Center across from Starbucks. Athletes, the time is now to get serious about improving yourself to reach your goals. We all know that college recruiters and professional scouts put a lot of importance on those tangible measurements, such as a 40 time, your vertical leap, cone drills, and so on. Proactive Physical Therapy in Tumwater has a special, unique training program that will improve your results across the board. If you are serious about raising your performance to the next level, you need to talk with the pros today at Proactive Physical Therapy. Check them out online or call for an appointment today.
Realtor Tommy Lowe of the Green Realty Group is the proud sponsor of the ESN Players of the Game. Remember, when you're looking to buy or sell your home, you need a partner in real estate success, and that's Tommy Lowe. Tommy believes in community and is involved as a youth football and soccer coach while supporting high school students. This is the commitment you get as your partner in real estate success with Tommy Lowe. Call Tommy direct at 360-791-3854 or go to his website at TommyLoweRealtor.com. That's T-O-M-M-Y-L-O-W-E Realtor.com. Tommy Lowe is your partner in real estate success.
Final score is on the board, and now it's time to recap the numbers on the postgame show here on the ESN Network.
And welcome back to Tumwater T-Bird Field. Paul Beatty, Tony Davila came up and took some pictures for us. We'll have those in the story later on, so we hope you'll join us. Take a look at that. We'll get that on later tonight. Game has been video recorded. I should say most of it has. I did not realize one of the power strips was not turned on, and so we ran through the battery of the camera. I think we lost the first maybe inning and a half of the game. For the most important part, all the scoring, I think we got on the video recording. So if you're watching the video recording, sorry about the beginning of it. I believe that did not make it to our YouTube channel. In the meantime, Bobcats here, they'll drop to 0-3 in league play. Tumwater goes to 4-0, 7-0 on the year. And the Bobcats, I think, overall are now 1-5 on the season. So the Bobcats off to a little bit of a frustrating start. Grant Larson, actually, I thought pitched very well for Aberdeen through four innings and got pulled in the fifth. I'm not sure why. I don't think it was much of a pitch count then. Maybe it's just a rotation that they had set, but he came out, gave up only the one run. Tumwater would finally strike in the third inning. Noah Andrews would walk. A base hit by Noah Circle would move him all the way around us from first to third, and then a sacrifice RBI fly by Jackson Davis would bring home Andrews. It was 1-0 after three. It would stay that way after four. Into the fifth, Tumwater would Noah Circle would walk, and then another walk to Jackson Davis. Fielder's choice by Hayes would get Circle on a force out at third, but runners on first and second, and Jacob Holbrook would get inserted, and he'd come through with a big two RBI base hit. And then he'd come around to score the third run on a pass ball. He'd get to third and take home, and then it was 4-0. And then in the top or the bottom of the sixth inning, Dustin Dahl would walk after a strikeout. Noah Circle, with his third base hit of the ball game, would move him over. Then Jackson Davis would step up with a two RBI base hit to knock home both the Noah Circle and Dahl. And then Holbrook again would step up with another base hit and an RBI for his third RBI in the ballgame. Logan Chase had a no-hitter going into the sixth inning. That was broken up by Austin Lawrence with a double. And then Logan could not finish the game. He got one out in the top of the seventh and then was pulled. Landon Jordan came in and he cleaned it up and took care of business with a couple of ground outs to Garrett Behrens down at first, and the T-Birds had their seventh win of the season and remain undefeated. Time now for our Tommy Lowe of the Green Realty Group Players of the Game. Remember, Tommy, he is your partner in real estate success. And when you're looking for real estate transactions, think no further than Tommy Lowe, the Green Realty Group. And our players of the game, our player of the game for Tommy, I'm going to go with Jacob Holbrook, who came in, had two at-bats, went 2-for-2 with three RBI, and scored once as well on top of it. So Jacob Holbrook will be our player of the game for the Tumwater Thunderbirds. For the Aberdeen Bobcats, I'm going to go with Grant Larson. I thought he pitched well. Gave up just the one run, kept the Bobcats in the game through four. The relief pitching could not hold it. And so we're going to go with Grant Larson as our player of the game for the Bobcats. Time now for the Proactive Physical Therapy play of the game, a game-changing moment. And remember, Proactive Physical Therapy, they are there to get you back in the game when you're hurt. Banged up a bit, get you back in the game over with the folks with Proactive Physical Therapy. And our play of the game is going to go right to the top of the first inning. Logan Chase, a pickoff move. There was a runner on second with no outs. And after a strikeout, then Chase fired a shot back to Noah Andrews on a beautiful pickoff move to get Oldham, and then all of a sudden, they're virtually their only scoring chance until the top of the seventh inning was gone, and that kind of set the stage and got Logan Chase refocused on the hill, and he rolled from then on, and the T-Birds did as well, winning it 7-0. Once again, tomorrow's baseball game has been canceled that we had on the schedule. I'm not sure if we're going to replace it, but it was Black Hills hosting WF West. They've decided to go ahead and play that game tonight. They're down at Chehalis right now. They had a game at 4:30. They turned it into a doubleheader. The forecast is for rain tomorrow, so the Black Hills and Chehalis say, hey, let's see if we can get both games in today. So they are playing those today. You can check our schedule to see if we replace it with anything. I'm going to say that we likely will not. If they're thinking it's going to be that wet, then the likelihood of finding a dry game is going to be tough to find anyway. All right, one more time, 7-0. T-Birds take it. They knock off Aberdeen. Thanks for listening, and thanks for watching. We'll catch you next time here on the Eli Sports Network.
Thank you for listening online to the Eli Sports Network. We'll catch you next time right here on ESN.